Okay. Are we there? Good. I'm still talking after all this all day. All right. Now we've got a really great. It gives me a lot of pleasure to introduce my next two guest artists. You know, one of which, you know, works as a key member of the Orojo team, Gerard Scarpesi. And then, and Randy, are both business partners, Gerard and Randy. Both business partners, and they met many years ago and had this idea that they wanted to communicate to hairdressers and really create a true network of sharing. And they created a product called Hairbrained. And, you know, I want to be around people that are visionary, and I think this was very visionary for me as a hairdresser, because it's about hairdressers being able to connect together in one place. And also, it's about hairdressers being able to profile their work. And they have thousands and thousands of members. And it's an amazing... I can hear Gerard talking to me in the back. I'm counting. You'll just stay there a second, Gerard. You're not ready yet. You're not ready yet. Do you know why he's not ready? Did anyone see Gerard last night at the party? Yeah? I'm going to tell you something about Gerard. Okay? He really should be from New Jersey, okay? And I love New Jersey. But Gerard likes to tan. Did you notice? Yesterday he said he went fishing. And I said, no, you didn't go fishing. You're all red like a lobster. Like you're bright red. And I said, and I can see the two lines from the goggles. Now when he comes on stage, I want you to imagine him stood in his banana hammock. I want you to imagine that sight, okay? I actually wanted him to come on stage this morning, but he said to me, he said, no, I'm not going to be able to because my tan's not going to have settled until about 2:30, quarter to 3. So it's about that perfect time. His tan has settled, and you'll see how it's gone from a soft pink to a golden glow. So you'll enjoy that. But truly, you know, Gerard is visionary, and so is Randy, and they're both hairdressers. And Randy works behind the camera a lot because he's really passionate about hairdressing. And he's going to be on stage with us today showing how great he is as a hairstylist. You know, I think hairdressers are the most creative people in the world. We can do so many things when we put our minds to it because we are creative. And because we have passion, and I think these guys really exude that. And I've been a supporter from the beginning because I do believe that what they've created is an amazing network. They actually participated a year ago. That was briefly after Gerard started to come on board my team. And I can tell you, Gerard is a massive influence for me. He's a massive influence in our industry. And I know that it's a massive influence for you guys. So without further ado, let's watch this great video, and then we'll introduce Randy and Gerard. Hairbrained, thank you. Thank you.
right, guys. Awesome. So this is Randy Taylor, and I'm Gerard Scarpese, as Nick so kindly introduced me. You know, and I think, you know, Nick's
one fan in the room.
Nick's been talking so much today, Randy and I have decided to do a silent demonstration just to clear the air a little bit.
Can we get an applause?
Well, you know, you see our message there. Our message really is about mentorship and community. It's so much show about community that I want to give a shout out to one of our members named Brittany from Intrigue. She essentially came up with that concept of share. See that word, share? It's a power. We really believe that language is powerful. And I think it's kind of somewhat underutilized in our industry. Obviously, what we do is very visual and technical. But the words really are the magic, as Nick was showing you today. You notice how he hasn't done any hair? He's just talked all day. Tonight, after a few drinks, I think. He's saving himself. No, but words are so powerful. And, you know, since I met Randy about 3, maybe 4 years ago, we've wanted to really kind of share what we do, share the passion, share the love of what we do. And we started out by creating, and I'll give the credit to Randy. It was really his idea. I'm kind of not a super technical guy, but it was really an idea that he had. I had the connections in the network, and he had the idea. So right from the beginning, it was about, you know, kind of connectivity and respecting other people's ideas. But back to Brittany, she essentially came up with the idea of the word share. We were at a trade show, drinking, as we normally do. And, you know, I was going on and on about, you know, how we need to get hairdressers to share more, because the magic of the things that we do on a daily basis behind the chair with our clients, we create beauty. You see that sign, love your work, we do? Do you think if this was a room full of chiropractors, it would say love your work, we do? Do you think if it was podiatrists, you know, they call it a conference. They get together and go to conferences so they can cheat on their wives. You know, for us, it's about passion. It's a different kind of passion. For us, we get together, you know, and we do this because we love it. We're here to share in the work that we do. You know, we love it. We're passionate about it. And here we are on stage. Many people don't know that Randy is a hairdresser. They know all these brilliant videos that he produces and all the amazing things that he's created from the technological end. But today, right here on stage, I want to introduce you to the hairdresser, Randy Taylor.
I know some of you. I saw some of my friends on the way in. Yeah, it's really cool to be cutting hair. So the video that you saw at the entry, that was sort of, you know, kind of like I thought about it for a while, and I thought, you know, why not really kind of explain our relationship? When
we're partners.
Yeah.
Business partners.
when I met Gerard.
Notice how Nick was so clear about that. I've trained him to say business partners so people don't get the right idea.
We snuggle a little bit, but.
I'm a anyway. Bear and he's a cub.
So I guess it was about 7 years ago that I was introduced to Gerard. And prior to that, I'd been cutting hair about 15 years. And, you know, I was a pretty successful hairdresser and teaching workshops and things. But, you know, what Gerard did for me was he really taught me how to cut hair with, you know, three dimensions and, you know, to really look at the bone structure of a model's head or a client's head, and to really take, you know, my haircuts to another level. And to this day, you know, I can't thank him enough for what he shared with me. And that's, you know, that's our message today. Our message is really just give it away, because what are you going to do with it anyway? You know, you can't take it with you. And, you know, there is no secrets. You didn't invent anything. Although we like to act like we did. We didn't invent anything. And, yeah.
Yeah, and the truth is, you know, we really believe in keeping things simple. The haircut that I'm doing here on Danielle, combination of very simple ideas. First was blonde. You know, we have to have this beautiful Goldwell blonde, really, really enlightened hair. Yeah, look at this beautiful blonde here.
Yeah, but look at this beautiful red.
Yeah, and a beautiful red. We wanted blonde and red really, really simply done. And just really popping. And then, you know, to me, over the years, I've gone around the bend. I've done some very, very complicated things. I've tried to reinvent and use algebra on people's heads and give everything like a deep, meaningful story. And then I realized, you know what? And I realized this a lot through Randy and the videos that he creates, because it's really just about the beauty of the hands and the craft. And it's really just about that kind of dexterity and really just doing things simply but really, really well. And I don't think there's anything more simple than beautiful razor cutting done really, really well. And with this haircut here, I first did an undercut all the way around. You know, I agree very much with Amanda that the late 80s, early 90s is a big, big influencer in fashion. So I remember undercuts happening.
Everybody our age thinks that.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. That's when things were great. Music was much better. But you can see the undercut.
Ever noticed that? Yep. It's true.
It was. This comes kind of from that time, the undercut. I know I sported one at that point, and, you know, you had a longer top. So I went in and I did this undercut. To keep it, you know, it's a subtle difference, but to keep it from being overly aggressive, I did it all with thinning scissors. And Danielle, my model here, she's actually a young hairdresser. She's a product of Orojo Cosmetology. Woo, woo, that's a success train right there, starting in the right place. And she was like, are you doing that all with thinning scissors? She had never seen it before, which I thought was fantastic. But the idea is, even just doing it, it just gives it a little bit more suede-y, soft edge. I built a little bit of weight here, and you can see the first thing that I did after that was I created a little bit of a line, a little box line, again with the razor. The razor creates that invisible texture and graduation. And now I'm fitting in another line. And this line goes back a little bit to about mid-ear, and that's going to be her fringe. And then I'm going to do another line. So this is just a combination of lines. But the idea here is that with masterful razor cutting, a line is much more than just a line. Because you're so engaged with the hair, you're working inside the hair with the blade. Now with this last panel, I'm going to bring this over, and I'm going to blend the line in here. And I'm going to really open the blade as I work my way through, because some of this hair will then flop over there. Very, very simple. And I think that's kind of, you know, that's always been my hairdressing message and my technical message. What are you doing with the haircut there? That looks a little bit like what Roger Thompson was doing on that video.
Really?
Yeah, didn't I ever tell you that video that somebody sent me of Roger cutting hair?
See, that's another trick. When somebody says, references what you're doing, act like you don't know what they're talking about. Because then you can claim it as your own.
Hey, you just said before you never created anything. Look at this guy. He talked about shady. He thought Nick was shady. Look at this guy.
You know what? These scissors are so sharp that I can't feel the hair. Mine are...
Trust me, if you put them on your finger, you'll feel them.
Yeah. So what I'm doing here, this is one of my favorite things to do. And I love, Jordan and I were talking about this backstage. I love the fact that in this economy, we can make a living with a couple of tools. And we came out here with those. I mean, obviously, we have cut, collar. We have a lot of support going on here. But a
couple of tools making a living. That's us.
Yeah. See, now you know why I needed Gerard in the business.
But you know what, guys? I mean, Randy's message is so true. I've got a comb and a razor. He's got a clip and a scissor and a comb.
I don't even have a clip. Not even.
You know, I've been meaning to talk to you about that, Randy. This guy, when we were doing our video, I'm like, where's your clips? He goes, I don't need clips. I cut on the 30 minutes in the salon. I don't use clips. Anyway, but
sorry for anybody that took a workshop with me and I had five clips.
But that really is, you know, that's the beauty of what we do. That's craftsmanship. There's no gimmick here, and we say that all the time. We're not really trying to show you any gimmick, and we're just trying to share the love of the craft. And, you know, that manifested itself in our online home of hairbrain.me. And I realize not all of you know what it is or not all of you have been to it, but I'm sure some of you have. How many members do we have here? Give us a choo-choo. And, you know, the honest truth is I've been in this industry now for 21 years, and I've seen many, many people that aren't hairdressers be very, very successful off of hairdressers. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that, and specifically in the media world. But I thought, and this is what really kind of got me into Randy's idea, I thought, isn't it time for hairdressers to be successful by publicizing other hairdressers? And that's really what we're doing. I mean, we haven't spent a lot of time talking about ourselves so much as we have everyone else. And, you know, that's the message behind. And I want to get back to that word share, because Randy hated it at first.
I didn't love it at first.
He hated it. He thought it was cheesy. And, you know, some people might, but if
I misspell enough. Yeah. And I just thought it would be taken that way. You know, I've actually, if you misspell something in an email, you'll get like 50 emails correcting you. I don't know if you guys have done that, but, you know, it happens to me all the time because I'm a hairdresser and, you know, I nearly flunked out of high school. But that wasn't because I was stupid. That was because I was uninspired. I really think we need a new way to teach our kids that are creative.
Yeah, put a razor in their hand.
Yeah. So this back cutting, what's brilliant about this is it leaves the color nice and shiny because anywhere you go, there's a solid panel of hair sitting over the top of the texture. Rather than just beating it to death with thinning scissors, which is just like taking your nice black shiny Mercedes and sandblasting it, in my opinion, my humble opinion.
Are you talking about Nick's car? That's what I'm going to be doing to it later tonight.
About that old banana. That's what I love about Nick. He knows how to have a good time.
Tomorrow morning, he's going to be like, what the hell happened to my car?
He's a serious businessman, but he knows how to have a good time.
Well, again, we've been talking about sharing, and I think it's time to share with someone else because, you know, a lot of what we do really wouldn't look half as good if it wasn't for brilliant makeup artists. And Randy and I are fortunate enough that we have, through the years, made friends with all different types of people. And the person I want to introduce you to is probably one of the most beautiful human beings that I know, quite honestly. He's got a smile that just is electric and megawatt. He was the international, global, galactic something or other, but he was the real main makeup force for Aveda for about 15 years. And he now is solo. And he's got his own company called Beauty by Rudy. Let's have a round of applause for Rudy Miles.
Hi. Oh, shucks.
If you don't already love Rudy, you will in 5 minutes.
Oh, fantastic. Hello, everyone. How are you? You're a good-looking bunch.
That's oh, fine. Thanks.
Oh, gosh. So thank you. Gerard and Randy, yes, as he said, we worked together at Aveda originally. And what I've learned over the years working with them is really as a collective, that's the best way to work and brainstorm. You know, as a makeup artist, my hat goes off to hairstylists. I don't get any of that. But what they're great at doing is helping me understand as a makeup artist where it's going. And they have a vision and direction right up front. So what we're able to do is collaborate and really come up with looks that are relevant. So what we wanted to create with this presentation was, you know, the new movement that we're seeing from makeup, it's all about color, whether it's monochromatic and natural or the use of actual color. So these concepts are the same. They both ladies are wearing monochromatic makeup. Just one is done with a blonde. We just chose to use browns and natural tones and peachy tones, which we know. It's kind of my homage to Kevin O'Coin. I think the conversation of, yes, you know. Oh, someone knows a makeup artist. You do makeup, don't you? My homage to the 90s as well. Kevin O'Coin was a major influence through the 90s for many of us when he brought the natural look right after the 80s, a period of full color and strong makeup. But if we look back at Kevin's makeup, even now, it's not so natural. I mean, it was full-on contour, brown lip liner overdrawing the lips. It was strong makeup. So that's the homage to Kevin O'Coin on the blonde. And then what we chose to do on this vibrant red color is the idea of makeup is back, but why not choose colors of the hair for monochromatic? So we chose, you know, red-orange eyeshadow and, you know, red blush. And knowing colors all relate together, so anything red goes with red. So red orange, red violet, even you can mix warm and cool, and just, you know, add a black eyeliner to make it smoky. So it's the same concept, just we use eyeliner to make it more intense. I love Hairbrain. The team asked me to mention Hairbrain because as a collective, where do we go to talk to each other about what we do? And social networking is so relevant today, but it's how you use it. Some people don't be bothered with it at all. But I love Hairbrain because it's how we talk. It's all of us showing our work, our concerns, our ideas together and collaborating. They also mentioned the idea of sharing. You know, as a makeup artist, I think of those who came before me who taught me what I know today. And they taught me openly and honestly. And so that's what I like to share with artists that I work with. Because if you show someone how to do this eye, if I show any artist in the room how to do this eye, you're not going to do it like I'm going to do it. You're going to do it your way. And that's the beauty of sharing. And it also keeps me as an artist on my toes so that the next time you see me, I'm not showing you that same eye. And you go, I already got that, right? So it keeps you fresh. So that's why I love working with the team. And what else you want me to say?
Round of applause. Thank you, Rudy. We love you, man. But so you know, love him? Did I lie?
Isn't he amazing? Amazing human being, really. If you ever get the chance to take a class or spend some time with him.
He doesn't care what brand makeup you work with.
Yeah, it just wears off on you, doesn't it? It's, you know, we have this thing, we talk about it a lot at Arojo, it's really all about who you hang around. You know, if you go into the staff room and there's negative people and they're talking about how things aren't great in the salon, you know what, just leave. Walk out and jump on Hairbrained. Because you know what, there's 16,000, Nick, just to be exact. You know how I am, I'm very detail-oriented. Just to be exact, we have 16,000 members, and every single one of them is positive. Every single one of them loves their job. Every single one of them that's on there is sharing the message of success. They're on that that train. I know we joke about it, but me and Nick have been talking about the success train for a while.
Hey, Gerard, you know, we should probably mention that Goldwell and KMS were the first to jump on board and sponsor us.
That's the absolute truth.
With some real money.
That's the absolute truth.
That allowed us to operate. Because before that, it was us defending ourselves to our wives saying, yeah, but we need to put another 10 grand into it.
Yeah, Randy and I put our own money into it for 3.5 years until John Maroney and Corey, they said, you know what, this has value to hairdressers. Even if it's not just a big ad or a mass email blast, buy our new product that comes out today. They had a little bit more than that. And they thought, sure, you know what, happy, successful hairdressers, those are our clients. What do you want? Try Refinish. It'd be much better on her.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm using... What? I just can't help it. It's the big silver can there, buddy.
Oh, this one.
That's it.
I'm finished. Nick's going to throw me out the back door.
But yeah, get back
to
that
message.
I've
shot videos of this. You want to pulse it, right?
Pulse it. You got it, buddy.
Yeah. See, I never knew what it was called. I'm too busy.
And I'm actually using a product. I'm breaking the rules here. I'm using our brand new curl enhancer. And you know, the thing about product is you got to put it in your hands and you got to feel it. And you got to think, is it tacky? Is it oily? Is it emollient? Does it have slip? And this is designed, you know, to put in hair and really promote curl. But I also found that it's got this nice kind of texture quality here. And
nice.
I got this monitor here, which is amazing. I mean, I could blow dry, but Nick told me, you have all the time you want, but just get off in 20 minutes. So... And I think it looks pretty good. What do you think? And again, the message here was simplicity. You know, honestly, if I was to do this without, I think, having spent 10 years razoring every day, it might just look like a little blob. But because of the way that razor engages with the hair and melts away the weight, I'm able to craft that line, remove the weight at the same time, and I think just get this really kind of beautiful, sexy. And, you know, normally, honestly, last thing I'll say, when Randy and I chatted, normally my thing, I think I'm a pretty mature hairdresser, and normally my thing is to do, I do. And my thing is to just do pretty wearable hair and say to people, hey, you don't have to go crazy. But when I had this opportunity with Randy to share the stage and come out, I said, you know what, let's push it a little bit. I still want it to be beautiful, but I want to push it a little bit. Randy's switching over to the camera here to finish up, and I think I'm done. I really don't think it's, I don't, yeah. Yeah.
Hey, G, can you just push my girl's hair around a little bit?
Oh, this is all wrong, Randy.
My assistant, Nick Arojo, is coming on. Yeah, so this is how I made a relationship with a lot of the top names in the industry, because I would show up with my camera.
He slept around.
And and I would shoot these images, and they would appreciate it, you know? And it really kind of...
Yeah, that's another great message, because people will say all the time, well, how did you
get
this?
They never get the pictures.
How did you get this? How did you get that? And, you know, this is maybe my last parting thought, because Nick's ready to bounce me. Yeah. The last message is people say, you know, how do you get this? How do you get what you want? Just show up. You know what? Just show up. Randy started going to hair shows just like all of you did, but he brought his camera and he stood by the door there. When everyone was finished with their models, he said, hey, can I take some pictures? Can we talk for a minute? I make videos. And he started making them and he started putting them on YouTube. We have a video that's on YouTube that's got 150,000 views.
Just a little haircut.
Shot on a flip video. So that's the last thing I'll say. If you want to be successful, show up, put in the effort, share what you do. Unyielding passion for what you do will pay off. Thank you. Goes to Stan.
Let's have a real big round of applause for Gerard and Randy Taylor. Models look awesome. Great, great job. So definitely go to harebrained.me and become a member. And you can friend Arojo. We have our own group, Arojo Professional. We can communicate. You can put your images up there. And we do a lot of our connection with Harebrained. We have an event called Happy Mondays, which we do all over the country. And continue to look for a Happy Mondays coming to a place near you, because we're going to be taking it to Minneapolis. And this year already, we've done it in many, many different cities. And it's a great tool for us to connect and share. And you guys still there? Gerard? No, they've already gone to the bar. So why don't we all go to the bar? And it'll take 5 more minutes. And then we're going to finish up with our final presentation of the day. Gerard Scarpese. And Randy Taylor, is he still here, or has he gone to get my car?
He's editing.
Oh, he's gone to edit. Oh, he's gone to get my car. We'll see you in a few, okay? Thank you.